You know what? Baird deserves to get the boot, especially after saying that CT doesn't deserve to be on the challenge. Like, in what world? Please don't put me in elimination. Please don't put me in elimination. Pretty, pretty, please. Hello, welcome back everybody to the video series dedicated show on MTV where you can love your country but hate your team. That's right, I'm talking about The Challenge Season 34, War of the Worlds 2, Episode 7. And in this episode, water sponsors a challenge in The Challenge. That's how you know you make it. The ground rules of not putting your own teammate into an elimination is now the golden rule everybody follows. And Tori talks about her relationship struggles with Jordan. But let's start off where last episode left off, and that was Jenny winning against Nicole in the elimination, coming back to the house. Not everybody is excited about that, Georgia. But CT talks to Turbo about how he's frustrated with his team. They're not winning. CT is a super competitive guy who wants to win, but he also feels like he's not being used to his full potential. CT has all the wisdom. He knows, he's so experienced in the challenge, yet he's not being used correctly because he's in the middle of two friendship alliances and he's just stuck in the middle. Like, but that all plays a role later in this episode. Let's just get into the daily challenge called Resilient River Run. And in this daily challenge, you have this giant puzzle of that looks like a tabernacle that they have to put on this podium that they can move around and carry as a team. And once they get that all squared away, they have to put it on their shoulders, walk as a team 400 meters down the river to pick up a giant relic head, put it on top of their puzzle, walk it all the way back to the starting line, put it on a podium, and then have to walk the puzzle 400 meters another way to get another relic head. The first team to get both their relic heads back to the starting line with their puzzle intact wins this daily challenge, makes it into the tribunal, and can put in somebody from either team into the elimination. And let me tell you right now, right off the bat, USA got a great head start on this whole thing. The UK was just yelling at each other, over on top of each other. They have one of the best puzzlers in the challenge history with CT on their team, but nobody's listening to him. The US gets it all together, they put it on their shoulders, and they start walking. And let me tell you, once they got that lead, they never looked back. Yes, there was times where the relic head was falling off of their podium a lot. Their puzzle was coming apart in the river. But you know what? That all happened to the UK team as well. And they just could not get themselves together to win this daily challenge. As US wins it pretty handily. I think they made the edit look a little bit closer than it actually was. But US wins it. And the drama doesn't come until after USA secures the win. Now, if you remember last season, and if you watched Turbo's Turkey Survivor highlights, after Turbo wins, he likes to do his Muay Thai moves, maybe do some flip kicks, maybe some roundhouse kicks, maybe turn into a panther at some point. There's two heads on the pedestals, and he decides to kick them off, doing two roundhouse kicks. Well, he knocks off one, and Zach, Ninja, and Jordan all get on him. Jordan puts it back on the podium, and Turbo's like, you know what? I want to do it again, so I'm going to do it again. And he decides to playfully kick it off. He's not doing it in spite of anyone or despite anybody. He decides to just kick it off again. And you know what? He does it. He kicks off one of them. He's all happy. And Jordan gets right up into his face with full aggression, yelling at Turbo. And Turbo decides, you know what? You're gonna get in my face. I'm gonna get you out of my face. And he pushes Jordan. And that sends everybody into a whirlwind chaos where production and everybody has to hold both of these guys back. Now, to put this all into context, Jordan was getting hung up on the little things all episode. From the very beginning, he was yelling about dishes in sinks. Granted, I'm a neat freak too. I don't like dirty dishes in the sink, but come on, are you gonna hang up your game and jeopardize $1 million because there's dishes in the sink? Come on, man. Apparently he is. He's enough of a control freak that he's going to freak out about anything if he can't control it. And in a team game, he cannot control everybody. So he freaks out about the dishes, and he's yelling at people during this daily challenge, telling them to shut up. Now, he's yelling this mainly at women. And he's being very toxic in this daily challenge, and he goes into his confessional saying, oh, well, the excuse is that I get results and my team wins, so I'm allowed to speak like this and treat people like this. That's just an excuse. Why don't you try to communicate effectively with people instead of yelling and breaking down everybody, because you're not bringing the team together or motivating anybody in this situation. Instead, you're breaking everybody down, you're breaking down the team dynamic, and that gives Zach the excuse to start splashing Ninja and telling her to get the F out of here because she's not helping anything. Yes, your team won, but to act like this is absolutely nonsensical. Well, this is a huge divide, and Turbo wants to be speaker, but Zach decides to be speaker, and everybody votes in Zach to be speaker. Zach puts into the tribunal Turbo and Tori. During the nominations to the UK, that's when CT goes off on everybody. The two people that everybody's voting on is either Rogan or Bear, and Bear is really trying not to get thrown into elimination one more time, but Rogan is appealing to everybody's heartstrings as he says earlier in the episode how he's the quote-unquote new CT, but when it comes down to it, he doesn't want to be put into elimination. He's like, oh, pretty please don't put me into elimination. I feel really sad if all my friends vote me into the elimination, and it's like, I don't think CT would have said that in a British accent or in an English accent or whatever his Boston mumble back in the day was. But CT gets super frustrated as he is the swing vote and he says basically to everybody, no matter what happens, everybody's just looking out for themselves and I'll look out for myself, and so I'm gonna vote in Bear, staying with the majority of the alliance, especially after Idris votes for Bear. And Bear is super frustrated. He wants to go against Rogan because he thinks Rogan doesn't have what it takes to prove himself in the proving grounds. That's when the tribunal goes on the boat ride and is like, well, what are we gonna do? And Turbo is dead set on saying Jordan, and he wants to go into the elimination with Jordan to mano y mano, see who's the better man. And let me tell you right now, Jordan back in the day, where he flipped over all the kill cards to go up against Johnny Bananas in the elimination, where is that Jordan? Instead, Jordan decides he is going to actually apologize to Turbo. Does he truly believe it? No, he doesn't. He's just saying that so he can be a good team player. I think this was all a ploy. I think Jordan getting into Turbo's face was all a ploy from the very beginning to get Turbo to swing on Jordan so that Turbo can be eliminated via production team, via the rules, so he doesn't have to go up against Turbo in elimination or into the finals if it turns out to be a solo game. But earlier in that day, Jordan goes over to Turbo, apologizes to him, they shake hands, they say, look, let's put water under the bridge, I will shake your hand and let's get on with the team and what's best for the team. In the tribunal, all three people vote in Joss, which is a blindside to everybody. Rogan, Joss, the whole UK team, and Bear. Everybody thought that Rogan was going to be put in, especially after Bear said that he wanted Rogan, but Joss gets put in. They have to go up against each other in the Wallop elimination, and this is essentially a hall brawl, but it's like a maze inside a hall brawl where you don't know when you're going to hit the other person. You're gonna just keep on running throughout these corridors, and you're gonna hit each other at some point, and you have to hit each other, you're gonna collide, then you're gonna have to try to get past the other person and run and hit your bell on the other side of this course first. The first person to do that three times, get 3 points, gets to stay in this game and gets to see if they're going to switch teams. Maybe they will, maybe they won't, probably not. Joss was super pumped, he was super ready, and he took round one pretty easily, but then Bear comes out of nowhere and wins round two, so now it's 1v1, and you think, maybe this could go down to the wire, maybe this can go to all five rounds, who's going to win? But realistically, Joss wins the next two rounds, winning 3-1, taking Bear home and giving Bear the boot. Joss goes bear hunting and he gets the final score, and Bear said he gave it his all, and you know what? Bear did beef up over the offseason and I commend him for that, but he's just not Joss beefed, and he's going to be sent home. Georgia is upset yet again for the second week in a row. They're just gonna break her down emotionally and mentally throughout the rest of this game, but Joss gets to stay in, and that's when we find out that Joss is a shower, not a grower, as he puts down his pants and shows that he wants to stay on the UK team. What a big shocker there. Nobody is still switch teams. When is anybody gonna switch teams? Why is this twist even in here? But that's it for this challenge. What do you think about it? Let me know in the comment section below. And what do you think about CT's speech at the UK nominations? I felt really sad for CT throughout this whole episode. We got a lot of CT, but it was just so sad to see him get so frustrated with his own team. What do you think about it? Let me know in the comment section below. But what do you think about this elimination? Did you think Joss was gonna win pretty handily, or do you think Bear put up a good fight? And what do you think about Jordan versus Turbo? Which side are you on? Are you on Turbo side or are you on Jordan side? What do you think happens? Do you think they really mended their problem? Or do you think that it's just going to escalate next episode or a few episodes from now? Let me know that in the comments section below. I want to hear what you have to say. I want to hear anything and everything you have to say about this episode, about this season. Let me know that in the comments section below. And while you're down there, hit that like and subscribe button. I'll be back really, really soon with more challenge videos. There's a challenge brief history on Saturday. We have Going in Blind coming out Tuesday or Wednesday. And join me next week for another challenge review and recap. But until then, peace.